14-Day Carnivore Challenge, Day 6, The Plant Paradox. I'm the author, Jason Atkinson. One of my main criticisms of a vegan approach, beyond it not being adequately nutritionally or sustainable for humans, is that it's easily abused by the food manufacturing and marketing industry. For example, at first glance, someone might think a vegan cookie is a healthier option, but if you examine the nutrition panel, you'll see it's filled with the most problematic ingredients just like any other cookie. All they did was remove the most expensive ingredients, milk and eggs, which were the only source of any actual nutrients this product might have contained, and thus extended the shelf life and increased their profit margin. This is what the food manufacturers are trying to do to our entire food supply. Protein dilution is real, and it has been on the rise since the inception of the original Dietary Guidelines for Americans. Plant-based ingredients like sugar, flour, grains, and seed oils are substituted for real food, usually animal-based ingredients, which increases the amount of a particular food needed to reach satiety as validated by the protein leverage theory. Our need for protein is so strong that it exerts a tremendous amount of leverage over everything else we eat. Humans will always overeat dietary fat and carbohydrates in an effort to sustain or to obtain sufficient dietary protein when total protein in a particular food is low. Let me say that again. Humans will always overeat dietary fat and carbohydrates in an effort to obtain sufficient dietary protein when total protein in a particular food is low. When we focus on animal-based sourced proteins and strive to take in roughly 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight per day, we automatically eat less of everything else. This concept is the underlying scientific principle behind a concept known as the protein leverage theory. This doesn't even take into account the inflammation, appetite dysregulation, and other negative effects inherent in the aforementioned ingredients. Vegan is a perfect example of what is known as the halo effect in food labeling. The general public doesn't have time to evaluate everything they hear in the media regarding what's supposedly healthy. So most people just gravitate to what's popular or what they hear being promoted most often. Food manufacturers know this and often slap a trendy label on their packaging to entice buyers to temporarily override their innate discernment regarding processed foods by offering selections that are low-fat or gluten-free or other buzzwords. The truth is that plant-based means nothing in terms of improving health. The most problematic ingredients, sugar, flour, and industrial seed oils, are all plant-based. By vilifying animal-based ingredients, the food manufacturers simply create a demand for their supposedly healthier alternatives. Plant-based is just the newest iteration of the low-fat idea that hurled the country headfirst into an epidemic of obesity and metabolic disorders. I'm not here to suggest we should just eat meat only and nothing else, but carnivore diet serves as evidence that it's possible to do this without suffering any negative health consequences. The bottom line is there's no justification for reducing animal-based foods to improve health. Animal-based foods are high in nutrients, and increasing their consumption usually improves overall health. Most of the negative health effects they supposedly have, promoted by the popular media, are based on epidemiological studies that involve dietary recall questionnaires and merely show correlation, not causation. Every single published double-blind randomized controlled trial shows higher protein and nutrients from animal sources have a positive impact on health outcomes. Even without scientific data, which is sometimes difficult to obtain because of bias on the part of researchers and difficulty obtaining funds for such research at the university level, there are thousands of anecdotal reports of people like me who have drastically improved health and fitness by increasing, not reducing, their consumption of animal foods.